Class, in the previous class we did that, what is our two experiments we did yesterday. One was the Frederick-Griffith experiment, and Frederick-Griffith experiment only we have studied the two different ways, that is first is he isolated the DNA, protein and RNA, and then he cultured the rough stain in that and found that is there, which one is actually able to cause disease. And he found that when the rough stain were cultured only in the RNA, DNA, they were able to cause disease. And in the next step what he did, he used the protease and DNAs in them. So say for example, this is the smooth stain or S stain, diploma of the pneumonia. In first case he put them and heat kill diploma of the pneumonia. He put protease in them. Proteins in them will digest all the protein. Then R stain were allowed to culture in that, and that was injected in a rat. And the second one, second case, he put DNAs in another culture, and he put after that R stain in that, and then it was injected into a rat. And he found that when only the protease is put, then the rat dies. Not in case of the DNA, they still remain alive. That means DNA's enzyme actually digested their DNA. As a result, the DNA is no more there, and R state could not change into smooth state. So these rats were alive. Protease digested only protein, not the DNA. So when the R stain were put along with that, nothing happened, because proteins are not responsible for the character or carrying of the hereditary character, it is only the DNA, and when they were injected into the rat dies. So this is how they came to know that the DNA is the genetic material. DNA is the genetic material. How can they say that DNA is genetic material? Because the changing of rough stain into right smooth stain is actually a genetic feature. And since the genetic character is changed by addition of DNA from the smooth stain into the live hard stain, and that is how they are changed or transformed. So it should be the DNA which is responsible, not the RNA. And that is how they came to know that DNA is the genetic material. But many people did not accept their experiment. Experiment was accepted, but this statement that DNA is the genetic material was not accepted. Because people were already predetermined that it is the protein, not the DNA. DNA cannot be. Because the protein has such a large number of possibilities. As I said, each character will be controlled by one kind of protein. So that means the protein is providing infinite type of possibilities, not the DNA. DNA alone made up of only 4 types of nitrogen bases, adding in thymine, cytosine, guanine. How much variation can they put? Whereas the proteins are made up of 20 different types of amino acids, and there can be as small protein as made up of only 20 amino acids to as large which are made up of infinite number. Like we don't know, we have not studied all the proteins yet. So we don't know that what is the largest number. But we have also studied the so far whatever we have studied. In that we found that there are the lakhs of number of amino acids are combining to form functional protein. So people were always thinking that the protein is a genetic material. They were not ready to accept that DNA is a genetic material. They thought that this state, it may be possible for this particular transformation, but not for all the hereditary characters. So this experiment of course paved the way for the selection of DNA material. Genetic material, but it was not accepted by a large community of people. So now we should go ahead with the next experiment. The next experiment was done by Cartier and Chase. Cartier and Chase. Conducted one experiment which is also known as Glenzer's experiment. This was actually conducted on बैक्टीरियोफेज वायरस इन विच द बॉडी इज मेड अप ऑफ अ प्रोटीन कैप्सूल एंड डीएनए. द वायरस बैक्टीरियोफेज विच लिव्स इन बैक्टीरिया दे ईट बैक्टीरिया हैव ओनली डीएनए एंड protein, nothing else. And we so far have decided that the genetic material should be either protein or DNA. So which one of them is actually genetic material was actually conducted an experiment by Hershey and Chase to find out. So what they did, they drew two cultures of the bacteriophage virus. One in which the sulfur was taken, radioactive sulfur, that is S35, and the other culture, the DNA was having protein P30. Sulfur is actually a part of protein, not in DNA. And phosphorus is a part of DNA, not in protein. So they developed two separate cultures, radioactive phosphorus P32 and S35 in the other culture. So in this virus, all the genetic material, that is the DNA, sorry, not genetic material, that time they were not aware. So they said all the DNA is containing P32 type of phosphorus. And in this, the protein capsule which is there was containing S35 type of sulfur. Now, what they did, they allowed them to infect Escherichia coli in a petri dish. Here also a petri dish in which large number of Escherichia coli are there, and they allowed them to infect it. As this bacteriophage virus actually eats bacteria, so this was the bacteria, and they actually infected it. So they were that is allowed to culture and they multiply. After some time, say for example after half an hour or 1 hour, so this is the mixture, blender rather, or in blender to jaate only one. So when they use this blender, put that the content in it, the superdentin from there. Superdentin you thought that contain protein, and the proteins were non-radioactive. Proteins were non-radioactive, but E. coli were found radioactive. In the other experiment, the other culture, when they use a blender and they blend it using the blender, what they found, the superdentin which were there, which contained protein, and they were radioactive. But the E. coli which were there, they were non-radioactive. So, in this case, since DNA is non-radioactive, the E. coli were also not radioactive. But in this case, the protein were non-radioactive, DNA was the radioactive, and E. coli were infected, they were also radioactive. So it was clear that it is only the DNA which is infected, not the protein. Protein was the gain. Protein could not enter in it. So since protein could not enter in it, protein has no role in the multiplication of virus. Okay, it's quite obvious. And multiplication of virus is actually a genetic character. So only the DNA entered in the thing. So if we see, if it is an E. coli, when virus entered, later on we came to know that when the virus infects bacteria, they only transfer their DNA, but the protein remain on the top only. And this protein was floating over here, which was known as the superdentin. And since in this case the protein was radioactive, this the protein which was there, As Rhesus is protein were non-radioactive, so then no radioactive found here. Paralysis is the protein were radioactive, so the superintendent were found radioactive. And here the DNA report taken as the radioactive could impede, so the E. coli were radioactive. But here the DNA was non-radioactive, so the E. coli which were there, they were also non-radioactive. So it is clear that the genetic material should be DNA and not the protein. Among the these two, that is the protein and DNA, the genetic material should be DNA, not the protein. If I put in this way, that the two friends are there. एक का नाम प्रवीण है, एक का नाम दिलीप. प्रवीण एंड दिलीप, दे वर गुड फ्रेंड्स. दे वेंट टू सम प्लेस, सम ऑफिस, टू पुट सम कंप्लेंट. एंड व्हेन दे गो टू द ऑफिस, दे फाइंड दैट देयर इज नो वन. दे वेटेड देयर फॉर 1 hour, 2 hours, बट नो वन इज देयर. नाउ द प्रवीण सेज, इट इज सो, व्हाई टू वेस्ट टाइम. दिलीप सेड, when we wasted this much of time, we should get its compensation. So Praveen asks, what you'll do? Dilip says, see, in the office you can see a mobile is lying there, and there you go, I am so picking this mobile and going. Praveen said, are you mad? This is not good. Praveen said, I am going, you do whatever you want to do. Dilip enters into the office, inflicts the mobile and goes. Now after some time, whoever was in charge of the office, he or she comes. So after some time, whoever was in charge of the office, he comes and finds no mobile. He immediately calls his assistant and asks, put the camera on and the recording and see that who came, and they see that this person is there. Of course they didn't know, but somehow they come to know that who is this thief, and they bring him. Who will be punished? Though they were together, but Praveen was not involved in clicking the mobile. So of course the punishment will be given to Dilip only. Here also, these two were there, protein and people Praveen, people protein, before Dilip, they got DNA. Praveen did not enter. It is only the Dilip enter, that is the DNA enter. DNA enters and multiplies. Multiplication of a virus is the genetic character. So this genetic is actually controlled by DNA, not by the protein. And henceforth we can say that DNA is the genetic material who proved it partial change. And why does one render the experiment? Because at that time there were no sedimentation machines were available, so they used a blender, and that is why it is also sometimes known as blender's experiment. Okay, so using radioactive substances labeling, they could find out that what is the genetic material, and henceforth now it is accepted as DNA is the genetic material. Abhi isme koi doubt nahi, so DNA is the genetic material. Okay. Now we shall study the structure of DNA. We already learned in class 11 the structure of DNA. DNA ka structure kaisa hota? DNA structure was studied by number of people. It was so complicated that in spite of studying by large number of people, nobody could actually tell it, because the structure itself is so complicated. But after a number of experimental findings, finally the best finding was of Rosalind Franklin, who was studying in the King's University in UK. And her finding also, she just put it, she could not explain it. And afterwards, two scientists named as James Watson and Crick. Watson and Crick in 1953 came out with the elaborated structure of DNA. What is the structure of DNA? We shall study here. A DNA look like this. like a spiral staircase. It's a helical structure and it has 10 steps in each helix. From year to year, one helix or one complete spiral, and the length of one complete spiral is 3.4 nanometers. The length between the distance of the two strands is 2 nanometers. It goes out here if I have it. So it is 2 nanometers. The width is 2 nanometers and the one complete spiral is 3.4 nanometers. And there are 10 steps which are made up of nitrogen base, and there is a fixed pairing rule, that is the adenine will always pair with cytosine and guanine will always pair with adenine. Four you can see, and the fifth one is here, and the next thymine to adenine or guanine to cytosine or cytosine to guanine and thymine to adenine and so on. So the distance between two consecutive nitrogen bases is, since year to year there are 10 nitrogen base steps, and the distance between one complete helix is 3.4 nanometer, so 3.4 divided by 10, that is 0.34 nanometer, is the difference distance between the two consecutive